Hey guys, so I thought I would kind of do a video just about veganism. I feel like that's something that I've kind of wanted to talk about, except I didn't really know how to because I just know that it gets a lot of controversy, especially online. I feel like people get really adamant about what side they're on, if they're vegan or if they're not vegan. I feel like their views are expressed really strongly, and I mean, like, at the end of the day, like, why are you so cut and dry? Why are you so, oh, it has to be this way, it has to be this way. Oh, you eat that kind of food? Oh, well, you shouldn't eat that kind of food. Like, you're messed up, you have problems, or something like that. So I thought I would kind of just talk about my experience. I'm not telling you should be vegan. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just sharing my experience and kind of providing tips if you are thinking about becoming vegan, if you maybe want to try it, or if you just want to watch this video. A common misconception about vegans is that we're always pushy, that we always want everyone in the entire world to become vegan, and we shove it down other people's throats. And yes, obviously we're vegan for a reason. We have our reasons. I feel like non-vegans get really defensive about it, or maybe they start attacking. I don't understand that. Like, I don't do that. I don't walk around and, like, yell at people who are eating burgers. I don't do that. I'm not yelling at people. I'm not going around saying, hey, you should be vegan. You should be vegan. Why are you eating meat? I don't do that. Because that's not cool. I'm not one to yell at people for living their lives the way that they do. I just think that that's not right. Another misconception about vegans is that we never get enough nutrients and foods that we need, but that's also entirely not true. I'm no dietitian, I'm no nutritionist, obviously, but if you do your research and you look at the labels on foods and you Google what vitamins and nutrients are in which vegetables and fruits, we get enough nutrients. I think that's weird. Like, why do you think we don't get enough? Like, why? We get enough protein, you don't need to worry, you don't need to, like, yell at us, like, yet vegans are getting attacked at for not eating enough, when clearly there's people eating fast food all day, and that's, like, somewhat, like, better. Definitely a tip if you are wanting to become vegan, or vegetarian, or gluten-free, or just a diet change in general, definitely do your research first. I'm not here to inform you in any way, but definitely do your research. I know there's stereotypes, I know there's misconceptions, and definitely research to make sure, hey, you know what foods you need to eat, you need to know what foods you can't eat, what foods you can't, and sometimes it's difficult. I found myself Googling, like, are pretzels vegan? Research before you make any commitments, anything at all. So definitely research. I can't, like, stress that enough, because another positive thing about doing research is being able to respond to comments like, where do you get your calcium from? Where do you get your iron from? How are you getting those B12 vitamins in there? How are you doing that? Are you going to be able to do that? I don't think that's possible. Peers or just other people in the world, or even, like, concerned parents, because that is a big thing. Like, your parents are definitely not educated about a dietary change, then you want to make sure you are, because you want to seem like you know what you're talking about. And I feel like your parents will take you more seriously if you present them with information. You'd be like, yeah, I can get my protein from these different types of foods, I get my iron from these foods and those foods, and I'm getting everything I need, and I know what I need. That's really, really helpful. Throughout my journey, let's see, about August, I started to switch to become vegan. I wasn't like, okay, August 1st, I'm not eating anything else. It was really gradual, and technically I wasn't 100% vegan until maybe like mid to end September. If someone asked me, oh, how long have you been vegan, I'll be like, yeah, since August, since the end of August, because that's when I really started, that's when I really eliminated 99% of all the non-vegan foods. that I was eating. Stopped eating meat maybe like early August, late July. And that was because I had jaw surgery and it was harder to chew on like meat. So I was eating a lot of softer foods and I realized, hey, you know, I haven't been eating meat. I mean, I'm kind of vegetarian now. This is interesting. Maybe I should try being vegan. So I let go of scrambled eggs, which I had a lot of because, again, I couldn't chew. And I said hello to tofu and to beans because they're softer foods. They were easier to eat. Eggs were pretty easy to let go of. And then yogurt, it kind of took a while. It probably took about a week to get used to not eating it. What kind of dragged it out into September was the protein bars that I was eating because they had whey powder in them, which whey is derived from milk, so obviously they're not vegan. I would say for a solid like couple weeks, the only non-vegan thing I was eating was those protein bars. I discovered Luna bars. I discovered other new ways to find protein. Like, obviously you would find it in like beans and tofu. So I actually discovered peanut butter powder and I started using that. A lot of people say they taste good in smoothies and I tried it in a smoothie and it didn't. I don't really like the taste of like sweet peanut butter. I like making peanut butter savory. So I would use the peanut butter powder. I use it in stir fries. You know, when I'm making stir fries, I like throw in some Thai sauce, throw in like my veggies, and then at the very end, a good amount of peanut butter powder. And I just kind of mix it in more sauce. So every bite has like a peanutty taste to it. My smoothie bowls that I have, I make smoothie bowls. And I think I have like, I get like a cup of oats in my smoothie bowl. A cup of oats is 10 grams of protein. You know, it's not like the highest concentration, but I was already eating the oats and I just looked at the label and I'm like, oh my gosh, like I'm getting 10 grams of protein from this meal. I thought I wasn't getting any. So now the cocoa powder also has protein in it. If you get certain ones, the certain ones don't have a lot of protein in them, but if you get like dark chocolate cocoa powder, some of them will have like a gram of protein per 10 calories, and that's pretty decent. Like, that's a pretty decent amount. Like, that's a higher ratio than protein bars. So I thought that was interesting, and I think I had maybe like a tablespoon or two in my smoothie bowls, which is, you know, like, yeah, chocolate and fruit, yummy. But it's like, hey, the chocolate's giving me protein. There's no added sugars. There's antioxidants because it's dark chocolate. I think cocoa powder is great. And you have to limit it to just dessert or just sweet foods. I mean, chocolate can be very savory. I will definitely try to. So cocoa powder and peanut powder are definitely like sources of protein that I did not expect. I've got some questions sometimes asking, how are you able to find all the food that you need at the supermarket? Because I don't live near like a Whole Foods. I don't live near Trader Joe's. I have a food line nearby. I can get everything I need as long as they have a produce section. Like I'm pretty sure every single grocery store has vegetables and fruits and canned beans. It's not like I'm starving and I'm like scavenging the grocery store trying to find stuff. People always think, oh, to be vegan, I need to have a Whole Foods. I need to have a Trader Joe's. I need to have a market or something that I can get my vegan food at. But, like, the hardest foods to find vegan are definitely like processed foods and junk food. I don't really eat that much junk food. I don't eat that much processed food. Obviously, the more prepared, the more processed something is, the less likely chance that it's going to be vegan. You know, like, so many processed foods use butter and milk and eggs in them. So it definitely is difficult unless you stumble across something that's accidentally vegan, or you actually look for those vegan products. Like I said, I don't eat a whole lot of processed foods. I don't really want to eat processed foods. The processed foods that I do eat right now are protein bars, Lara bars, and granola. And those are kind of just snacky things. Lara bars are really nice because they have so little ingredients. Lara bars and Kids Organic. I find them at my local co-op store. I do think that Target is a good resource if you have a Target near you. But Target is definitely a good place to get kind of your junk food. I know I get my Luna bars at Target. And I used to get granola at Target, and then I found another one that I liked. And then I liked more Food Lion. You don't have to buy all of your food in one place. If you need to go to different stores to get your food, I think that's fine. I know that Clif bars are really popular, and I do like Clif bars. They're more of an indulgence for me, so I don't like having them every single day. Okay, my camera shut off. Not shut off, but it stopped. Literally after 30 minutes it stops. I didn't know that. I've never made a video this long. I was talking about food. Wow, that's what this video is about. But I think I got all my points out. My telling about being vegan. I didn't really have a plan for this video. I hope this helps if you're trying to become vegan, or if you've been vegan a while, or if you're just making any kind of dietary change. So I think that is it. Let me know if you want me to go in depth about more specific things, about if you have any questions, I'll try to help you answer them. Like, I'm not an encyclopedia, so I'm obviously not gonna know everything. I hope you